Hai guys, balik lagi sama gue Winnie dan Fova. Nah, pembahasan kali ini adalah Fova bakalan jelasin ke kita seputar ball. Bener, right Fova?
Yep. Today we will speak about balls. It's the one of the most important and necessary equipment in shisha. So, depend how the smoker or customer choose the ball, in the end they will have different result.
Okay.
So, we know that strongness level is coming from tobacco leaf because nicotine is inside, and depend how much nicotine in tobacco leaf, as more nicotine you will get, as more stronger tobacco and smoking process will be. But we can control steaming process, and to control steaming process we can use different kind and shape and material of balls. So in here on our table we have different balls, which
six
is
balls.
Yeah, this is six balls, which is all actually representative of the market now in Indonesia, what you can choose. So the most popular, it's a ball from MVP setup, yeah, from company Aladdin. It's a sphere bottom ball, straight smoking process inside. So you just install tobacco, make the central hole, and you can start smoking. This ball is how we can call it, it's a little bit fluffy. So yeah, the material is fluffy. So if you compare, for example, with this one, this is Turkish ball, they look same, almost the same, but they have different characteristics because Turkish ball have much more clay inside. Clay are not pressed, but kind of clay is so strong and so heavy, so to warm it up you need much more time. And this ball is much more pressed, not fluffy. I mean, like, material inside, you know, like, for example, in here, in this ball, you get a little bit more air inside. That's why to get warm up it's much more faster. And after that the temperature will be much more higher, because the spreading of temperature inside is much more faster than in this ball. So this is actually a normal ball for smoking. It's not bad, possible to smoke, but if you choose this ball because of the fluffy material inside, you should count on high intensity of steaming and high intensity of aroma, because as more hotter, yeah, tobacco and the ball has more intensive steaming process, and aroma coming much more faster. Yeah, this one is a classic ball. Yeah, almost like a Turkish, but because of material, it's not. Yeah, and the Turkish ball, as I said you before, it's also the sphere bottom ball, also straight smoking process like inside, and the Turkish ball have very fat walls. So if you warm it up once, you will get the temperature much more stable inside. So if your charcoal is smaller, getting smaller, the ball still keeping the heat and temperature, so it's more easy to keep the same level of steaming. This is very stable ball, yeah? Inside it's very big holes, which is making you more easy to inhale. And actually this ball is possible to use for the strong smoking process, yeah, for the process of smoking based on burley, tobacco leaf and everything else. You don't need, also it's very easy to use that ball for smoking without central hole, because of the holes in the bottom, it's so big, it's very easy to inhale. The smoking process is not broken, yeah. Yeah, the second one is also, it's very popular ball in Russia, and that ball called Upgrade Form, the classic small shape. They also have in their production the bigger one, but this one the mostly used because the amount of tobacco inside around 20 grams.
20
grams. That ball made from white clay, as you see, it's everywhere white color, and this ball is also kind of fluffy balls. Yeah, they have the very comfortable
shape.
If you put aluminium foil, it's very easy to fix it. Yeah, this, maybe a few years ago, it was one of the most popular balls I ever saw in my shisha department where I was working before. Yeah, also very good for intensive steaming, for strong smoking smokers, and for smooth also good, but if you produce smooth tobacco on that ball, aroma can be steamed too fast. Yeah, like if customer or smoker expect smooth smoking process, it's gonna be smooth everywhere. Not only nicotine, but also gonna be smooth with aroma. Next ball is a
killer.
Yeah, the killer ball. It's very interesting ball. This is flat bottom ball, also with the big holes. Yeah, the very fat walls. So the ball is kind of stable balls. So for what we use the flat bottom and what is the difference? Actually, you have tobacco. Yeah, and you have hot air going through tobacco. Yeah, and everything is necessary inside. Each single angle of hot air inside is necessary. Position of tobacco is necessary.
Yeah.
If you have sphere bottom like that, and tobacco is going and hot air is going like that, the parts near with the wall, it's not very active in the smoking process, and also bottom. So you get, normally you get all nicotine from the top and middle of the bowl. But if you have flat and you have kalut or aluminium foil on top, you get straight bombing of tobacco leaf by hot air, and the amount of nicotine you get from tobacco leaf is much more higher. So you get more intensive steaming, not only aroma, but also nicotine from tobacco leaf. And tobacco leaf position is like directly perpendicular to hot air, yeah. So this is normally the ball for the strong shisha, for burley tobacco leaf, for something with a really high amount of nicotine, maybe something like a cigar, tobacco, or something like that. And also, we have a non-straight smoking process bowl. We call it funnel. In here, we put tobacco around. We put it in here, and the central hole already done. You cannot block it, because if you block, it's very difficult and complicated to inhale. That's why normally we install in that bowl something like smooth tobacco with big amount of juices and molasses, because incomparable with the straight smoking bowl, if you install tobacco in here, all juice which is getting warm, getting more liquid, and that juice and molasses aroma fell down in the into the shaft and the waste. In here, your tobacco position is on the bottom of a bowl, and there is no holes.
Yeah.
So the old juice, which getting more liquid, stuck in the bowl and still working. So it's not going out. When on funnel, if you can control it on the right way, you can smoke a little bit longer. And also funnel bowls very, very often made with the glaze on top, also to keep that juice inside, not absorbing by bowl like in here, because you know clay can absorb.
Yeah.
And in here it's not. So the funnel bowl can be different types, from the clay, from the stone, from ceramic, and also from silicone. This is very stable bowl, because you know that the coefficient of spreading temperature in silicone is much more lower than in the clay or in other materials. So you get temperature spreading out on the very smooth way. In here, the model called Samsaris, so you can install in each single section different flavor.
Yeah. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yep.
6 flavor, is it okay?
Yeah, but.
Wow, cool, yeah.
Can be like a fruit tartare, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Inside.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Yep. Normally, but I normally use it to, I use 2 sections, because if you mix 6 flavors, you should recognize all of them.
And to recognize
all 6 flavors, you need to do balancing on much more detailed way than it's proposed by that bowl, yeah? So, yeah. I guess actually for this bowl and for the funnel bowl and for the stable Turkish bowl, which is very stable heating process inside, would be great if we can use something like tobacco. Yeah, that product can be fit in each single
bowl.
Yeah, because it's stable. Yeah, even if we speak about the bowl, which is more easy to overheat. Yeah, which is fluffy. This tobacco, I was really wondering, when you place that tobacco in that and you get overheat, you just do several blowout. like puffs out from the shisha, and the temperature goes down, and tobacco still working. It means that marination of tobacco was very good, and all juices and molasses go inside. So when liquids getting overheat, it's not steam out and disappear, because big amount of juice, molasses and flavor is inside of tobacco leaf, mm-hmm. not on the outside. This is something really, really good for tobacco like that, and I like it very much. It's smoking very nice. And actually, for the main database about balls, it's that's all from my side. Only one topic I want to say for everybody.
What is that?
Yeah, that we need, if we want to reach a good level of smoking process and shisha, we need to always work on stability of heating management. Yeah, so find out your temperature, find out your balance, and what is more comfortable for you, how it's more comfortable for you to smoke it. Yeah, find out your tobacco, your level of nicotine and everything. So actually, my recommendation to get in your home, if you are a home smoker, the big variation of the balls. So if for you comfortable to smoke on the killer, maybe for your friends or your customers will be comfortable to smoke on the funnel. Yeah, and you can wonder your friends with the big availability of the flavors and the big availability of possibilities of smoking. Yeah.
Nah, tadi udah jelas kan, Fofa tuh udah benar-benar detail banget jelasin seputar bowl. Jadi setelah nonton video ini, gue harap kalian lebih paham nih cara memilih bowl, cara memilih tembakau, biar shishanya tuh lebih nikmat, bisa long lasting. Karena kayak yang Fofa bilang tadi, sebenarnya tembakau atau muasal juga bowl itu saling mempengaruhi nih. Jangan kemana-mana, tetap terus tonton video gue, karena gue dan Fofa akan selalu sharing tips seputar dunia shisha. See you on my next video. Gue Winnie dan Fofa. Bye-bye.